Okay, before we can talk about uses of electromagnets and how an electric bell works, you need to know what an electrical circuit is. Okay, electrical circuit basically means that from the power source, which is the battery, electricity has to flow around. Okay, so in this case, is this an open or closed circuit? Now, if you look over here, you will know that it's an open circuit because the switch is open. That means the path of the electricity is broken. Okay, now if you look at the next slide, is this an open or closed switch? Open or closed circuit. Okay, and you will know that it is a closed circuit because the switch is connected. There are contacts. So that means electricity from the battery can flow around. That's why it's called a circuit. It needs to go around. Okay. So let's start. Let's go to the electric bell. Now, if you look at the way the electric bell looks like, okay, you will see that there is an on-off switch here, which is the same as this switch over here, okay? Now, there is the power source, which is the same as the battery, okay? And if you look over here, this is the whole circuit, okay? All these things in black, okay? This is the coil, this is the electromagnet, this is what's supposed to be a circuit. Now, when the switch is in the off position, this is an open circuit. That means electricity from the battery or power source cannot go around because there is no contact here, okay? So, oh, we talked about that. If you look at the red thing over here, the red path, you will see that if the switch now is turned on, electricity from the cell can flow around all the wiring. Okay, so the red line here, that's the wire. That's where electricity will pass. Now, if you remember the electromagnetism experiment we did, usually, the wire that they put around here is made of copper. And you can see that the wire is coiled around this metal object here, which is acting as the electromagnet, okay? So what will happen to the electromagnet? So you can see the blue bars here. When electricity passes, as you saw yesterday, the 2 days ago in our experiment, when electricity passes over here, this magnetic material becomes magnetized. Okay? So when it becomes magnetized, which metal object will it attract? Okay? It's going to attract this metal object, which is connected to the clapper or the ringer, the thing, okay, the object that hits the bell. Okay? So there you go. So it attracts this piece of metal. Okay? And it hits the bell. But what happens when the electromagnet attracts this metal, which makes this clapper hit the bell? Is it an open or closed circuit now? So if you look here, you will see that the lines or the pathway is black again because the circuit is now open. So even if the switch is on, okay, the circuit is open because it's broken over here. There's a gap. Okay? So what happens to the electromagnet? The electromagnet loses power and therefore it is demagnetized. Okay? And so what's going to happen to this part? It will go back, okay, to its original position, which is this position. Okay? Now, when it goes back to the original position, what happens? It becomes a closed circuit again, so electricity will go around, and this magnetic material will magnetize again, and it's going to attract this piece of metal, and the clapper will hit the bell, but the circuit is broken. Okay, and this will keep on going on and on until we turn the switch off. Okay, so you can go to okay, so let's watch what happens. Okay, so you can see there's the pattern. Closed, open, closed, open, closed, open. Close, open. So what happens to the electromagnet? Let's do that again. So what happens to the electromagnet? Demagnetized, magnetized. Demagnetized, magnetized. Demagnetized, magnetized. So every time the magnet is the object is magnetized, the bell rings. That's how the electric bell works. Now it's the same concept here. So as long as you know what happens to an electromagnet and circuits, then you will be able to figure out what will happen in the other types of circuits. Okay? Good luck!